also vote him out of Congress.
What's like just one smack in the face after another?
Families already on the brink of poverty in the pandemic. The I-Team uncovers hazardous code violations, all at one address. Safer at home? We investigate Thursday on News 12 at 6 o'clock.
You want local news that impacts you?
We got you covered.
We're on your side.
On your side, this is News 12 First at 5.
Volunteers on the coast are pretty blown away. Baby sea turtles are pretty special on their own, but this little guy, he's one in a million.
Plus, groups across South Carolina are pushing for better protections in nursing homes. New numbers are driving those efforts.
But first this evening, students have been in and out of the classroom all year, but this week, thousands of sixth graders in Columbia County are officially back in the classroom full-time.
Starting this week, they return to five-day in-person learning. 7th and 8th graders in the county, they're set to do the same in the coming weeks.
With more kids in the classroom, school leaders are making some changes. News 12's Brady Trapnell gives us a look inside.
For 6th graders in Columbia County, school looks oddly normal. Other than masks, school officials say classrooms are full. Dr. Caraway says the change to full-time is most noticeable in the cafeteria. Only a quarter of students can eat in the cafeteria, so some are eating in classrooms or the gym to keep social distance. Inside those classrooms, sixth graders are in a class with 20 or so other students again. School officials say anywhere social distancing isn't possible, students and staff are required to wear masks. Dr. Caraway says with the changes, about 20% of students in the district are learning from home now, but the COVID numbers gave them a chance to try full in-person learning.
In our 7th grade, we hadn't had a positive case since August 21st. And in our 6th grade, we had only had two since September the 4th. We are trusting and requiring that our students and staff follow our good measures. And if they do, we're going to be able to have school successfully.
Now, Dr. Caraway says they are giving students mask breaks in certain safe areas. And we spoke with parents to see what they think about these changes on News 12 at 6 o'clock. Reporting in Columbia County, Brady Trotnell on your side.
7th graders in Columbia County are set to return to full-time face-to-face learning next week, and then 8th graders will head back the week after that. And a heads up for Aiken Innovate families, if you want your student to stay in virtual learning or switch to face-to-face instruction, you have to let the district know. The form to do that is opening through the parent portal this Friday. This will be your only chance to switch your learning model for that second semester. And in Richmond County, the Board of Education getting ready to meet tonight. They're expected to talk about school closures and contact tracing. That gets underway at 6 o'clock, and we will keep you updated.
Taking a live look now over I-20 at Grovetown, as some of you start to get off work and head home, a reminder, if you drive in the area at night or early in the morning, you can expect some road work, which means slowdowns, of course. In just an hour, crews will start working again near exit 190. They're out there to fix some concrete issues on the road. That work is happening from 6 p.m. until 6 a.m. It is expected, though, to be finished by Friday.
Lots of cloud cover out there as we check in with Chief Meteorologist Riley Hale.
And looking at a different stretch of I-20 that we know has been under construction now for a little while, beautiful look at it. Courtesy of Earth Camp, we're seeing a nice afternoon. Temperatures near 80 here in Augusta, but that is one of the warmer spots. A lot of us staying in the 70s today, thanks to these bad boys above us. This cloud cover is preventing us from reaching temperatures as warm as what we got yesterday, but we're getting close. Louisville is probably the hottest spot out there, 83 degrees currently. A little bit cooler in Aiken County, 77 in Aiken, 78 at SRS, and the rest of us kind of mix of mid to upper 70s. Very nice evening up ahead. We are going to stick with the cloud cover through this evening and tonight as well. And with clouds overnight, that's going to prevent us from cooling off too much. Temperatures generally staying in the mid to low 60s through most of tonight. Now Wednesday, we're not expecting much rain early on, but as we head throughout the day, there could be the opportunity for a few stray showers out there. Much more on those rain chances tomorrow, just a little bit.
A new study shows South Carolina has the highest COVID-19 death rate in nursing homes nationwide. Recent data from the AARP shows more than 5,100 people in state nursing homes have gotten COVID since January, and 940 of them have died. Data from DHEC shows nearly 40% of South Carolinians who died from the virus lived or worked in long-term care facilities. That's why six organizations across the state are coming together to urge leaders to put better protections in place for people living and working in these long-term facilities. In a letter to Governor Master today, they're calling for equal treatment.
We have a whole group of citizens who
are still sitting there waiting to be treated like everybody else. And part of the problem, of course, is that right now we have the pandemic going. Often people with disabilities end up trapped in institutions, and that's one of the worst places to be during this time.
Those efforts follow the 30th anniversary of the Americans with Disabilities Act. They say it's time to do something about the issue.
An officer at Winthrop University is off the job after being accused of sexual battery against a child and a teenager. SLED agents just arrested 48-year-old Charles Price. According to arrest warrants, the alleged incidents happened between 2007 and 2008 and involved both an 11-year-old and a 14-year-old. He's now facing multiple charges, including criminal sexual conduct with a minor.
We're learning more about a wrongful death lawsuit against the city of Atlanta. The family of 8-year-old Sequoria Turner says they're suing for $16 million. The lawsuit seeks $2 million for Sequoria's wrongful death, another $2 million for her mother, and $2 million more for the driver of that car. Investigators say Sequoria was shot and killed inside a car on the 4th of July. They say she was killed by armed demonstrators protesting the deadly officer-involved shooting of Rayshard Brooks.
In South Carolina, the upcoming U.S. Senate debate between a rare sight on Kiowa Island. Volunteers with the island's Turtle Patrol spotted this rare white sea turtle. It just hatched. Typically, baby sea turtles are gray or even green in color, but as you can see, this one is creamy white. The group says it's most likely because of a genetic condition. They say this is extremely rare. This was the first white turtle spotting for everyone on patrol. Pretty cool stuff there. All right, remember this adorable moment? Healthcare workers at University Hospital getting a well-deserved pick-me-up from dogs from the Stinky Kiss Animal Rescue. They tell us they'll be doing this again soon.
This happened last month, but the sweet moment is a contender for the Spread the Joy contest, and it could win the shelter $25,000. Today is the last day you can vote for Team Stinky Kiss before their contest ends. To do that, you go to our website, you search Stinky Kiss, and the link to vote is in the article, so check it out.
We are staying dry for the rest of our Tuesday, but heading into Wednesday and Thursday, likely going to squeeze out a few showers. Take a look at how much we're expecting coming up.
And imagine going to the fair and never even getting out of your car. That's right, it's 2020. Things are weird, and the South Carolina State Fair is going drive-thru. We'll show you around after the break.
Looks like just one.
Breaking news just into our newsroom. The Augusta Commission voting to end the Augusta Fire Department's ambulance service for 1 year. The move comes after a motion was put forward to fire Augusta Fire Chief Chris James after complaints of training, morale, and an outside assessment of his department. The commission's legal team now has 30 days to come back with plans for the next steps. The South Carolina State Fair will look a whole lot different this year. That's because for the first time ever, it's going to be a drive-through event.
Yeah, strange, right? Organizers, though, have been hard at work making sure you can still get the fun of the fair without ever getting out of your car. Madeline Cudahy gives us a look around.
We are so excited for our 151st South Carolina State Fair drive-through event. It has certainly been a year like no other, but we can just kind of feel the excitement in the air.
This year's fair, a drive-through experience, will take cars safely through a whirlwind of state fair exhibits, sights, and sounds.
Nobody gets to drive through the fairgrounds when the fair is going on, so you'll come in the front gate where the rocket is and just start driving through the fair, and you'll just start seeing a lot of familiar things that you would see during the traditional fair.
You'll see the Calliope. You've got a little bit of circus at the fair that was previewed last year, a little bit of fun entertainment along the way, and of course, I think one great thing this year is the way we've been able to showcase agriculture.
And when you've had your fill of South Carolina cheer, there's pretty much one thing left on people's minds.
Fisk fries.
Favorite Fisk fries.
I'm hearing a lot about Fisk fries.
Yes, the beloved Fisk fries will be there, along with a host of other treats, delivered safely with a no-contact drive-thru.
For the food, you get to have your whole little parking lot there, and you can enter from Gate 6 off of George Rogers Boulevard. We've got 3 miles of queuing in there. Your corn dogs, turkey legs, sausage sandwiches with peppers and onions, all without, funnel cakes, elephant ears, cotton candy, candy apples, red and caramel, and caramel corn.
And though it may be a little shorter this year, the fair is still here to serve the people of the Palmetto State a whole bunch of joy.
The fair is a tradition where, you know, 151 years is a long time, and it's very, very important. education, and now more than ever, people need something positive.
It'll just be a nice, free thing for people to do. The weather's great, so come on out.
Right there next to Williams-Brice Stadium, but what a creative thing, a drive-through fair.
Hey, you know what? My favorite thing about the fair is food anyway, so right. I wouldn't be too bad, mad about driving through it.
Everything they mentioned sounded great.
I know. Now we're hungry. Everything's going to look good now, Richard.
How about some catfish?
Okay.
Put it in the books.
Yep.
This guy now holds the Georgia State record for catching the largest blue catfish. He's holding a record all right there. That's a big bubba. Both those guys. We're talking about 110 pounds of fish, just short of 5 feet long. Tim Throne is the fella who reeled in the beast on the Chattahoochee River in Stewart County this weekend. Blue catfish, they're common in Georgia waters, but usually, what, 1 to maybe 20 pounds? But can you imagine the fight to get that one in the back of that truck, Riley?
Ooh, that is a big boy right there. And I've heard of some big blues at Clark's Hill, but I've never seen anything that big.
It's monster.
Monster fish there. And hey, great weather out there today for fishing. We have cloud cover moving in, dropping pressure. Fantastic conditions if you can sneak away for the afternoon. We are warm again, up to 80 here in Augusta. Above average for this time of year, and that's actually going to be the trend for the foreseeable future. We are expected to stay above average all the way through the weekend and even into next week as well. Here's a look at our long-term outlook. So this projects if our temperatures are going to be above or below normal over the next or the 6 to 10 day outlook. So this is past what we were just looking at, and it looks like we are going to be the one location across the U.S. to where we're expecting above average temperatures while the rest of the country enjoys a nice cool down as we head towards Halloween. But for us, it's really just about the cloud cover, warm temperatures this afternoon. Looking at visible satellite here, you can see that cloud cover is really starting to build in from the south throughout the day, and it's going to stick with us through this evening and tonight. We're not seeing much in the way of rainfall, though, so there are some showers closer to near that I-95 corridor. Not expected to be a huge issue for us here in the CSRA. Through this evening and tonight, we are going to stick with the clouds and maybe even some patchy fog forming early tomorrow morning, so watch out for that on your morning commute. Throughout the day Wednesday, we're not expecting widespread rain, but there is going to be the opportunity for some of these stray showers. Nothing looks to be all too heavy or all too widespread, but if you do get clipped by one of these, it could last 20, 30 minutes, so you may just want to have that umbrella in the back seat just in case. That'll extend into Wednesday afternoon, just kind of these isolated downpours possible even early and late in the day, but nothing that should last all day long for you. Heading into Thursday, since we're likely going to see a few showers Wednesday, some low-level moisture will likely allow this dense low-level cloud cover and fog to form again early Thursday. Notice temperatures Thursday morning expect to be pretty warm, actually about 10 degrees above average, about 10 to 15 degrees above average, mid to upper 60s expected waking up Thursday. And Thursday is going to be the same outlook. We're expecting it'll heat up throughout the day back into the mid to low 80s, and that'll likely be able to generate just a few stray showers out there throughout the day Thursday. So the next couple of days, we're not expecting a lot of rain, but there is going to be the opportunity for a few stray showers out there. The higher rain chance still expected to be Friday into Saturday, but hopefully looking dry for sunshine.
Riley, thanks a lot. You hate the cold, want to head south this winter? Well, the Columbia Airport has some new flight options for us. We're going to see where they're headed after the quick break.
Why does John us now?
As the weather gets colder, the Columbia Airport is giving you more chances to take that beach getaway. Starting in December, a new low-cost carrier will start flights from the Palmetto State to South Florida. It is called Silver Airways, and twice a week, it'll make trips to Tampa, Orlando, and Fort Lauderdale. You can expect initial fares to be as low as $50 one way, and you'll be able to spot their planes. They're the hot pink ones with flamingos on them. With the new Florida destinations, the Columbia Airport now has nonstop flights to 9 major airports in 8 U.S. cities.
$50, what a deal. General Motors making a multi-billion dollar investment to have one of its plants manufacture electric vehicles. Renovation at the Spring Hill, Tennessee plant is set to begin right away. First up on the assembly line, the electric Cadillac Lyriq SUV. Production expected to begin late next year. GM says the move is in late 2022, I should say. GM says the move is a push forward on their commitment for an all-electric future. So here it comes.
Visitors traveling on I-95 South through Georgia can now make a stop and learn more about one of the state's natural treasures. A new Okefenokee Swamp exhibit is now open at the Georgia Welcome Center in Port Wentworth. It tells you everything you need to know about the swamp and why its tourism is so important for the economy. The Okefenokee Board of Trustees says they hope the new exhibit will bring in even more people.
Well, we are certainly trying to make it available to the people who have gotten restless by quarantining at home and ready to be out in a natural environment where it's safe to be, where there's fresh air, and where there are things to learn about nature and the way God created this world.
The Okefenokee Swamp on the Florida-Georgia line is home to hundreds of unique animals and plant species. It already brings in more than 90,000 visitors every year.
A former SEC quarterback is about to...
Staying dry for the rest of this evening and tonight. We are expecting some patchy, dense fog to form by early tomorrow morning, so watch out for that if you do have an early morning commute. Temperature-wise, tomorrow morning, expect to be in the 60s out there. Tomorrow afternoon, we'll most likely hit the 80s again. There is going to be a little bit higher chance to see a shower on Wednesday, so I'd keep that umbrella nearby just in case you do get a quick little shower. Now, the Columbia County Fair does open back up